All right, now it's time for our home inspection. So you found the house that you like, you're in your inspection period. What do we do now? So your inspection period is gonna be negotiated in your contract, but typically what we're seeing in South Florida is about 10 days. And like we discussed before, your home inspection, the way the contract is worded, it says at the buyer's sole discretion for any reason whatsoever during your inspection period, you can back out of the contract. So we wanna make sure you are completely satisfied with the condition of the property. With that being said, all the sales are as is, so you wanna make sure any of the things that you know upfront are factored into the price of the house that you're agreeing to and offering. So if you know the kitchen needs to be remodeled or it needs new flooring and you wanna do that kind of stuff, make sure that's factored into your initial offer, because if you come back after the inspection, you say, well, the kitchen needs to be remodeled and we want you to reduce the price by $10,000, that's likely not gonna happen. That should have been factored in upfront. Now, the inspector's gonna check the roof, the AC, the plumbing, the electrical, the appliances, the duct work, the pool equipment, the sprinkler equipment, anything you need to know about the property, that's what the inspector's there to inspect. So there's four inspections that you're gonna need to get. One is the comprehensive inspection to go over all those things we just discussed. The next is the wind mitigation, which is what you need to get insurance on the property. Then if the property's older than 30 years, you need a four-point inspection, and then you're gonna want a termite inspection. So the cost for all those for a single family house in our area, typically, and it's gonna range depending on the size of the house, but somewhere between $400 and $600. So the inspector's gonna give you what's about to, it's probably like a 30 to 50 page report. Don't be alarmed, it's totally normal. It's like that on every single house. You're paying this home inspector $400 to $600. It is their job to find something. Every home has things that need to be updated or that need some fixing, even new construction. If you do an inspection on some new construction, I've found properties that, you know, were just built a couple months ago that have issues that need to get fixed. So do not be alarmed if there's a bunch of minor things on the inspection report. On the report, the inspector is also going to give you the approximate price to fix any of these items on the report. So let's talk about how those are priced out. The inspector has to give you the price for each individual item if you were to call a serviceman, electrician, whoever, to fix that one thing. So for example, the building code changed in South Florida, and in every bathroom you need a GFCI electrical outlet. Those are the outlets that have the button in the middle that you can press to reset it if it trips. So an inspector is gonna have to tell you that each of those outlets is gonna cost somewhere between $100 to $200 to fix. That's if you called an electrician and he came out and fixed one outlet. Now you might see 10 outlets in the house that need those, and you might say, well, that's, you know, $1,000, $2,000. If you call an electrician and he comes out and fixes all of them at one time, it's going to be significantly cheaper than whatever you add up the price to be, but that's how the inspector has to write it out in the report. So don't be alarmed and just tally up the total of things that need to get done and expect that to come off the price. You have to think about what it's actually gonna cost. So we can call an electrician. A lot of times what we can do, we can send the report to the licensed contractor that you wanna use, the electrician, the plumber, the AC person, whoever it may be, and have them give you a real quote to fix the items that are on the inspection report. And that's a much better idea to get a realistic answer versus just adding up all the numbers on the report. So we're gonna review the report together, and we're gonna go over which items we need to get addressed and which items we knew about and are cosmetic and are just there for you to know about. So these contracts, it's as is with the right to inspect. So don't go in there and now you have the homeowner contract, you did the inspection, and yet now say, well, the kitchen needs to be updated, so now we want you to reduce the price by $10,000. Realistically, the seller's probably not gonna do that. That should have been factored into your original price. The inspection is really just to reveal any defects that you couldn't see when we were touring the house. Obviously, we're not checking every electrical socket in the house when we go look at it. We're not looking and seeing the different types of plumbing in a lot of instances. We're not checking, you know, the pool equipment to make sure there's no leaks in the pool pump. That's the inspector's job. So it's there for to see things that you couldn't see with the naked eye. We're really looking for big ticket items. Are there any roof leaks? Is the AC cooling properly? Is there a bad type of plumbing? Are there bad electrical panels? Things like that, and that's part of what we do when we go in there. We're looking for the major items to make sure that you don't have any surprises when you do your home inspection. So that's really what we're looking for. And now here's how we address it. You have a couple options. You could ask the seller to fix those items, but here's why I don't recommend that necessarily. The seller is going to be incentivized to do any work to the property as cheaply and quickly as possible on their way out the door. In my opinion, the better way to do this is to get a credit from the seller so they pay for some of your closing costs. That frees up the money that you were going to have to bring to closing so you can call your plumber, your electrician, your whoever, and do the work yourself after you close on the property. That way you know the work was done correctly by someone who you chose, so you just have more confidence in the work that was done. I don't ever want to have a seller say, oh, we did something and it was done sloppy and you're not satisfied with it. So that's inspections. That's typically how we deal with any of the items that came up. If you have any questions, comment them down below. Give me a call, shoot me a text, send me an email, and stay tuned for our next video.